In this video, I'm gonna show you how to add cheats on PCSX2, the PS2 emulator for PC. This is a new version of my original video on this topic, as I didn't cover a lot of details on adding not only the cheats on PCSX2, but also how to label them and make things more optimal. If you don't already have PCSX2 fully installed, you can watch my guide video for that. The link will be on the description, because this video will focus just on the cheats themselves. Let's get going. So here on the emulator, the game I'm gonna be using as an example is the American version of Black. And it is important to know the region of your game, because the cheats also needs to be on the same region as well in order for them to work. And if you don't know that information, the emulator will tell you. Right here on your game, you're gonna click on it with the right button, and you're gonna select here Properties. This window will show up, and it will have the information we need: the serial code of the game, and also the CRC. The serial is the region code information about your game. In this case, the American version of Black is 21376. And we also need to know the CRC code as well, but that's for later on the video. If you followed my emulator setup guide video, you have the portable version of this emulator, right? With all the folders needed here on the same location. And the cheats folder is already here as well. This was already created by the emulator, and this is where you're gonna be dropping the cheats file. But if you did the default installation, then this cheats folder here will be on your document, and we can get there from the emulator right here. You're gonna click on Settings, then select Folders right here, and we'll list the directory of these folders, including the cheats as well. Right here, you're gonna click on Open, and it's gonna take you to the cheats folder of your emulator. Keep this one open here, because we're gonna come back when we have the cheats with us. You can get cheats for PCSX2 on many places on the internet, but there is one place where you can find a bunch of them together, already labeled and working, and it is on this website right here. I'll put the link on the description. And to start, you're gonna put your mouse here on this codes, so we can see the systems available here. So you're gonna select Sony, of course, and then click on PlayStation 2. It will take us to this page right here, and you can find games by clicking here, or you can search them as well. So in my case, I'm using Black, right, on the PS2 as an example. So I'm gonna type the name of game, press Enter, and it's gonna list the games with cheats here. I can already see the game I'm looking for, right, here with Black. And like I said, I have the American version of Black, the NTSCU, and they also list the serial code as well, the region of this game. And it is the same one that I have here with me, just to confirm, 21376, the same one right here, so I'm on the right path. So when you find the one you need, you're gonna click here on the region, and it's gonna list the codes available. Now, on this page, you have to do this every time you go into a game list here. On the format, you're gonna click right here and change this one to PCSX2.pneg. This is the format we're gonna need, and also change this from all to checked. If you leave this on all and select the cheats you want and click on download, it's gonna download all the codes in here, not the ones you selected. So it is important to always check this option here. Now, scrolling down here on this page, we have the master codes, and these are not needed for PCSX2, at least not anymore. I'm not sure if this was a requirement before the updates, but you don't need them now. And here we start to see the first codes for these games. On this section, you're gonna see more specific codes, like stuff that unlocks certain levels of the game, something like that. And below that, you're gonna find the codes you are probably looking for, stuff like infinite ammo, infinite health, and so on. It is not unusual to find codes here that do the same thing, but they were uploaded twice. This means that one of these codes are now outdated and it does not work anymore, and the same person who worked on that have put up a new version of that cheat. For example, we have two codes for infinite ammo that was done by the same person, but you can tell that this one is different than the others. And at least on this game, I found out that the codes that have the least number of strings here is the new one. This page will not tell you what codes are the new ones, at least I did not find any filter for it. But if you do come across two codes, just get one of them, test them out and see if it works. Unfortunately, there's not much you can do about this. So to download these codes, you're gonna check mark here on the cheat you want, and then you're gonna come back on the top and click on download, but you can pick more than one cheat at a time. For this example, I'm gonna get the codes for infinite ammo and also infinite health as well. So select them, go back to the top and click on download. I already have the file here with me, but we have to rename this in order for it to work on the emulator. And the name of this file has to be the CRC code of your game. Remember that? Here on the emulator, right click on the game, select properties, and it is this CRC right here. So you're gonna have to copy this, press and hold with the left button on your mouse, select everything, click on it with the right button, and then copy. Now go back to the cheats folder, right click on the file, select rename, delete all of this, and then just press Ctrl V and press enter. There you go. Now the file is ready on the emulator. I'm gonna show you that right now. If you had this open, close it and just do the thing again. Right click the game, select properties. Now here you're gonna go to the cheats tab and your codes will appear right here. And to activate them, you have to click here on enable cheats, and you can now highlight these boxes. So you just have to click on the ones you want to use and you're good to go. You just have to close this and start your game, and the cheats are gonna be there. In case you get a code from the internet that is not labeled but it does work, you can add the label yourself here, and it's very simple to do. I'm gonna do that right now, and I'm gonna use the same code as an example. Here on the SpNAC file, if this is your first time, I don't think you're gonna be able to just double click and open this with a notepad. If that's the case, you're gonna right click this file, select open with, and choose notepad from here. If notepad does not show up, then you're gonna click here on choose another app, and you're gonna select the notepad from there or your favorite text editor software on Windows. And when you do that, you can just double click on the file and it should open. And here we have all the information we need about these cheats. But the only part that matters for PCSX2 in order for the cheats to work is this one right here where it says patch, and then you have a bunch of numbers and letters. Some cheats will only have one string of code while some will have two, like the one that I have. But what I'm trying to say is you might come across a code that only has the patch part here. You don't have a description or even the name of the code, right? Let's say I got this code for infinite ammo, but I only have the code itself, right? There is no name, no description or anything. I'm gonna start by giving this code a name, and I'm gonna use this one as a reference because the name of the code always have to be between brackets. So you're gonna start by open bracket, and then you can just type the name of the code right here. When you're done, close the bracket. Now you can press enter, and I'm also gonna give a description as well. So just type description equals, and then you can write a small description to your code. Remember that these labels are optional and it does not have to contain everything. You can write a label for just the name of the code itself and you're good to go. This is gonna be up to you. Don't forget to save right here, or you can just press Ctrl S on your keyboard and you can close this. And I'm gonna show you that the change that I've made here will be detected by the emulator. Right click the game again, go to properties, cheats, and there you go. The name and the description of the code is now different and it will work just as fine. Just make sure you have it marked here and also click on enable cheats as well. And when you start your game, the cheats will be there and you can start playing with them. I have many videos like this on the channel covering how to install and play games on PC with the best settings for performance and graphics. So if you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and as always, I'll see you soon.